Well, one of the big reasons Dave is leaving us is to spend more time with his family. Look at those beautiful people. And you travel out east to visit your parents and your sister, I know, as much as you can. So we know how important they are to you. And so I had a chance to reach out and chat with your parents this week. Bill and Sheila.
Didn't.
Let's see what
Did
they have
you?
To say. Yes. Joining us from upstate New York, Mr. and Mrs. Schwartz. How are you guys doing today?
We're doing fine, thank you.
Yes, yes.
Good.
A little chilly.
Well, it's a little chilly here, too.
I bet it is. You know what chilly means, yeah.
That's true. Well, I have to say, I have loved working with your son for nearly 15 years. I'm here with Barry White. It's just been, been so wonderful. I'm so excited about where he's going. I'm sad about him leaving, but I'm so happy about his new job. Tell us about what you think about him moving to the Minnesota Wild.
You know, I think it's almost like this plan started when he was 8 or 9, because he became, you know, totally involved with hockey.
Yep.
But at the same time, he was totally into our little home movie camera. And so it was almost like it was meant to be that he was a sports person. And now to wind up at the Wild is just, that's his dream come true. I know he'll miss everyone, but this was meant to be.
Tell us a little bit about Dave when he was little. Any funny things?
I'm not.
Oh, God, yes.
Oh, okay, yes. I'm trying to think, of course.
Well, he used to try to stick with the cameras.
Oh, yeah. He would always be filming.
Yes.
He would always be filming. And he just, he was always into sports of some kind. Mm-hmm. You know, he was, and he knows I've said this, he was mediocre at best in most everything, but he gave it everything he had. And he thoroughly enjoyed the process of playing, you know, football and baseball. And I mean, he tried everything, wrestling, everything. He just really enjoyed being involved in sports. And he accepted the fact that, you know, he wasn't going to make it the big time, but now he's in the big time.
Good evening, everyone. The new baseball season has just begun.
We have the early audition tapes from Syracuse that were during the show. So what was it like the first time you saw him on TV?
Oh, my. I thought he had a long way to go.
Finally tonight, it's time for Schwartz's Shorts.
But, you know, knowing him, and certainly after all these years, he tries his best.
Yeah.
He just pushes and he gets better and better and better. When he was in high school, his English teacher, whom he did not like, basically said he was a lousy writer.
Even though the Syracuse Flyers enjoy the friendly competition they get here every week in the gym, what they really want is a chance to play some legitimate competition.
And so that made him determined that he was going to get better at it, and he worked at it and worked at it and worked at it. And I mean, I'm really in awe of his stick-to-itiveness.
Dave Schwartz, NCC Sports.
He's a really great writer, a great storyteller.
He's a wonderful storyteller.
The KARE 11 News Saturday show has given him the opportunity, let's say, to do some cooking, which I know you guys watch the show on Apple TV.
Yeah.
You have to admit, he's come a long way.
They may be cooked by next week.
By the way,
I have
lots of good things.
Real new respect for all the chefs that come on our show.
I guess so.
It'll probably be pretty weird that he won't be on TV anymore.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, but I think he wants to move on, and it'll be okay.
it'll
be okay. Yeah, yeah. It'll
he
be.
Wants his dad, he wants to, you know, hang out with dad too. So.
Yeah, I think, you know, having weekends with his family, you know, with the kids and with Shannon. I mean, that's going to be wonderful. That's just going to be great that they can do, quote, normal things.
You're right. Yeah, the television world doesn't have any normal hours. We all know that. So
that
that'll be wonderful. Well, thanks for your time today.
Oh, it's delightful.
Thanks for calling. It was nice to talk to you.
Good to see you again.
I know. Yeah. And thanks for sharing your son with us. We appreciate it.
Yes.
Oh, thank you.
And they're watching on Apple TV right now.
I
love your mother. It's hilarious. Well, he was mediocre at best.
Well, wonder where I get my quick wit from. It's her. And you being very kind. I was not a good athlete, but.
How about those audition
Where
tapes?
Did you find those?
Your wife.
Oh, that makes sense.
I would die if those popped up.
I love that. I love that.
Oh.
I love them. They have been in 20 years that I've been doing this, my biggest cheerleaders.
Right.
And always watching whatever they can and always cheering me on and always being there for me. And so even though it was mediocre at best, my mother, I remember having conversations with her and I'm going to be a professional hockey player, and yes, you can if you want to. And clearly, that was not what she thought, but I love you so much for saying that anyway.
And look at this. Now you work for a professional hockey team,
it works out
great.
Yeah.
All right, so I think it's time to drink.
Okay,
you know
good.
What I mean? Because
yeah,
it's 48 past 8. I mean, come on.